ओं नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपपुनरैतः प्रज्ञानघन प्रत्यगतो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभूम वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तंतोटकं वार्चिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् संततमानतोऽस्मि। श्रुतिस्मृतिप्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहि च कृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। So we finished the Ratna Prabha section looking at the Tika. What was said is, what is introduced now. Earlier what was said is Nimitta. The implication of the word Nimitta, what is indicated in the Bhashya by saying Mithya Jnana Nimittaha. Nimitta has been used by Bhagavan Bhashyakara to show three Hetus which were elaborated in the Ratna Prabha as Ajnanasya Upadanatvyapi. Although Ajnana is an Upadana, Upadana Karana, still Nimitta word has been used to show that Nimitta also it is. Meaning, Samspurad Atma Tattva Avarakataya Doshatvena Ahankara Adhyasa Kartu Ishwarasya Upaditvena and Samskara Kala Karmadi Nimitta Parinamitvena Cha. These are the three Hetus. As having Avarna Shakti, Ajnana which veils the Swayam Prakasha Atma, Samspurad Atma, Atma Tattva. That is a dosha. That is one Hetu because of which it is also Nimitta for all this. And the word Nimitta has been used. Second reason is Ahankara Adhyasa Kartu. Ahankara Adhyasa, Samashti Ahankara Adhyasa is there even in Brahma whereby he becomes Ishvara. The Ajnana is the Nimitta for that. Although he is not under the influence of it, but still, because he is Jagat Karta Ityadi, therefore there has to be Upadhi which has to be accepted for Brahma. That is second reason as to Ajnana is Nimitta there. And third reason is during the Samskara Kala, the Samskara is acting in every Kala where Karmadi are being done because of Ragadvesha, and for those also this avidya is karana, ajnana is karana, therefore nimittam iti uktam. And what happens to that vishaya which is there where karma is being done to, due to raga, to the pravritti towards the vishaya is due to the raga, and one does karma, pravritti, or one does karma for nivritti from the vishaya where there is dvesha, that vishaya is also ajnana parinama, therefore also nimitta. Therefore what nimittattvam iti dyotayitum nimitta padam. That is what we saw in the last part. The swaprakasha ityadi in Ratna Prabha is introduced by the Tikakara by saying swaprakashe, tika, swaprakashe tamorupa avidya katham. On one hand you say atma is swaprakasha. You have said samspurad atma tattva. then you go ahead and say avarakataya. Now the Atma Tattva, Brahma Tattva alone is there, which is Swayam Prakasha, Swaprakasha, Atma Tattva. And then avarana of that is due to ajnana. This is the reason, first reason where you say nimitta word has been used, whereby nimitta word has been used. Now this ajnana, where is it? It has to be in Brahma. Now you have already established that tamah prakashavat viruddha svabhava between ahamkara, which is karya of ajnana, and atma, which is Brahma itself. So the tamas swarupa of the karya, ahankara di karya, is due to ajnana, which is itself tamorupa. So this ajnana avidya, which is tamorupa, when its karya itself cannot have any tadatmya aikya with Swayam Prakasha Atma, how is this tamorupa avidya in Swaprakasha Atma? So Swaprakashe tamorupa avidya, Swaprakashe Atmani tamorupa avidya katham? Further, Atma is also what? Asanga. Brahma is Asanga, Asanga Atma. So asange hi avidyayah sangascha katham, and asanga brahmatma, how does it have sanga, be it tadatmya sambandha or whatever you are talking about, as adhara adhya bhava, between ajnana and brahma, how can that be possible? Avidyayah sangah asange brahmatmani katham sambhavati? Iti anvayam abhipretya aha. Considering these two questions in the anvaya there. Aha swaprakasha iti. Ratnaprabha, swaprakasha atmani asange katham avidya sangaha iti shanka nirasartham mithyapadam. So the mithya shabda can also be seen, mithya jnana nimitta, as mithya indicates that the sangha as well as ajnana in swaprakasha atma is mithya. And what is mithya here? It does not mean nasti. It means yatkinchit bhava rupa avidya asti eva, ajnanam asti eva. And what is that? It is neither sat nor asat. So sarasat vilakshana avidya ajnana is there. So Swaprakasha Atma, so two questions. Swaprakasha Atma, how can it have Tamorupa Avidya? And second question is Asanga, so Atma, how can it have Sangha with Avidya? So he says, Katham Avidya Sangha Iti Shanka Nirasartham Swaprakasha Atmani Asange Mithya Padam. This Mithya tells you that there is no Sangha, real Sangha isn't there, and Ajnana is not really there in Brahma also. It is not really existent at the same level of satta as Brahma, Brahmatma. Eka, shanka nirasartham, shanka dvaya nirasartham ityartha. So shanka nirasartham, although the way the doubt has been put in Saratna Prabha, it is swaprakashatmani asange katham avidya sangaha, not asanga atmani katham sangha, that is not the only doubt. So swaprakasha atmani, so what has been said is swaprakasha atmani avidya katham. This avidya sangha word can be broken into two, avidya sangha, avidya and avidya sangha. So swaprakasha atmani avidya katham and asange atmanaha sa sambandha katham. So these are the two sangha. Sangha katham means sambandha katham sambhavati. So there are two doubts hidden in a single sentence which is not clear. Therefore, Tikakara says shanka nirasartham. And that is why he said that in the introduction itself to the Swaprakasha. Shanka nirasartham means shanka dvaya nirasartham. To refute the two doubts. What are these doubts? Prathama shankam pariharati. What are the answers to these doubts? Prathama shankha, shankam pariharati prachandeti. So a drishtanta is given. Just because something is seen or inferred, it need not be right. So prachandeti in Ratnaprabha, an example is given. Prachanda martanda mandale pechaka anubhava siddha andhakaravat. Aham ajnaha iti anubhava siddham ajnanam durapannavam. So durapannavam. He says you cannot disagree to your anubhava of aham ajna, which has been mentioned earlier as well. Now example given is to counter swaprakashatmani. In swaprakashatma, how can there be tamaha andhakara? So an example is given as to prachanda martanda mandala. Prachanda martanda mandala, the huge sun which is there, which is like a which is swaprakasha, and its prakasha is overwhelming. You cannot even look at the sun with closed eyes for a long duration. Bright sun, not the rising sun or the setting sun, but the bright 12 noon kind of a sun, you cannot look at with closed eyes also. That kind of a sun is not seen by an owl. So pechaka anubhava siddha, pechaka is the owl. The owl cannot see the sun, it sees darkness. It can see at night. So scientifically you forget that it can see infrared and all that, but the example is to drive home the point that one may see darkness in swaprakasha atma also. Not darkness, but avarana may be there, meaning one may not be able to see the atma, just like the owl cannot see the bright sun. Although it is so bright that one cannot miss it. Nobody needs to point out the sun. The sun is clear. In fact, it may not be clear as to where exactly the sun is, because you cannot even look up in the sky. The sky is completely lit up and one is unable to even look up, let alone find the sun. The sun is clear. That's why we say clear as daylight. In Brahmaloka, it is said that avidya and atma are clear like day and night. That is the clarity, the viveka between Brahma and avidya, atma and avidya is clear. Atma and anatma is clear like day and night in Brahmaloka. So jnana there is easy. Going there is very difficult. But jnana there is very easy. Therefore, krama mukti is easy having reached there. Anyway, that's an aside. Swaprakasha atma can also appear to be dark. Tamorupa avidya can veil it. It can be in it and it can veil it. How so? Just like an owl can not see the sun. But is it true? Is it true as in the sun is dark? Is it true? That is not true. The sun is non-existent. That is also not true. Just because the owl cannot see the sun does not mean that the sun isn't there. Therefore, mithya, it is bhranti. It is a bhranti of the owl, scientifically whatever it may be, but it doesn't prove that there is no sun or the sun is not bright. So that is the example. Prachanda martanda mandale pechaka anubhava siddha andhakaravat. Just like andhakara in the surya, as per the owl, anubhava siddha. If you tell the owl, no, can't you see this bright sun? The owl can't see it. No, I can't see it. If it could talk, then it would say, I can't see it. So it is the owl's anubhava. Similarly, the ajnani's anubhava. Even if the jnani says, can't you see? Can't you see the atma tattva? It is your real self. How can you miss the swarupa? Ajnani can't see it. Like the owl. So anubhava siddha. Aham ajnya iti anubhava siddham ajnanam durapannavam. You cannot say it isn't there. It is anubhava siddha. This was said earlier also. Now with an example, it is being established as to katham you cannot ask because it is there. Now you have to explain. With an example, it is clear. It is possible. Sambhavana is there. So this is sambhavana vashyam. Earlier there was an akshepa samadhana, and then there was this is sambhavana bhashyam. This section is called a sambhavana. So it's a possibility. The Purapakshi is handheld and shown that is there a possibility? Do you agree that the owl cannot see? That much you agree with. Now how can you say that there is no anubhava? You look into your own anubhava. Aham ajna is an anubhava. Therefore you cannot say it is impossible. There is a sambhavana. It is possible. Tika. स्वप्रकाशे दृष्टांत सहित अनुभव बलात् अस्ति एव अविद्या न स्वप्रकाशत्व हानिरपि. सो स्वप्रकाशे दृष्टांत सहित अनुभव बलात् सिंस देयर इज एन अनुभव वंस वन अनुभव एंड दृष्टांत आल्सो एस्टैब्लिशेस दैट देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी सच अ पॉसिबिलिटी देयर बाय अविद्या इज डेफिनेटली देयर. ओके देन स्वप्रकाश हानि स्वप्रकाशत्व हानि आत्मस्वप्रकाशत्व हानिर्भवति न भवति. जस्ट लाइक द सन जस्ट बिकॉज द औल कैन औल सीज अंधकार इन द प्लेस ऑफ द सन डज नॉट मेक द सन तमः तमो रूप. सिमिलरली हियर ऑल्सो स्वप्रकाशत्व हानि वोंट बी देयर बिकॉज आत्मा रिमेनिंग स्वप्रकाश इज वेल्ड ड्यू टू द अविद्या ऑफ द पर्सन हु सीज तमो रूप आत्मा और डज नॉट सी आत्मा बाय आवरण. अनुभवस्य भ्रमत्वाद इति भाव. व्हाई सो? बिकॉज अनुभव मे बी देर बट इट इज नॉट यथार्थ अनुभव. इट इज अयथार्थ अनुभव. इट इज नॉट तद्वती तत्प्रकारक अनुभव. इट इज भ्रम भ्रमत्वाद इति भाव. पेचका उलूका इत्यर्थ. उलूका द औल इन हिंदी दे कॉल इट एज उल्लू. सो पेचका मीन्स उलूका इत्यर्थ. द्वितीय शंकां परिहर्ति. सो हाउ असंग आत्मा कैन हैव संगा विद अविद्या. दैट शंका निराशा इज बीइंग डन एज कल्पितस्य इति. रत्नप्रभा कल्पितस्य अधिष्ठान अस्पर्शित्वात्. सो द कल्पना ऑफ अंधकार इन सूर्य डज नॉट हैव एनी एसोसिएशन विद दिस स्वप्रकाश और ब्राइटली लिट सूर्य. देर इज नो संबंध एट ऑल. जस्ट बिकॉज अंधकार आरोप इज बीइंग डन अध्यास इज बीइंग डन ऑन सूर्य. सूर्य हैज नो आइडिया ऑफ अंधकार एट ऑल. इवन एट नाइट वी कांट सी द सूर्य. सूर्य गोज एल्सवेयर बट ऑन सूर्य फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द सूर्य इज देर एनी अंधकार. सूर्य कैन सूर्य no andhakara also. It's a rhetoric. Surya cannot know what is andhakara. Similarly, from the atma perspective, there is no ajnana at all. There is no tamaha. There is no samsara. So sangha bhav duram. Atma in the paramarthika drishti, there is no avidya, no tamaha, no samsara, no prapancha. Where is the sangha possible? There is no dvitiya. There is no bheda whatsoever. Thereby kalpita, all prapancha, ahankara adi prapancha, the tadatmya sambandha, the samsarga, all these are kalpita. And therefore, being mithya, there is no संबंध विद अधिष्ठान. अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज द डेजर्ट. जस्ट बिकॉज देर इज मिराज वॉटर इन डेजर्ट सीन बाय समबडी ड्यू टू रिफ्रैक्शन. हाउएवर द वॉटर विच वुड अदरवाइज मेक द अधिष्ठान वेट कैनॉट मेक द डेजर्ट लैंड वेट बिकॉज ऑफ वॉट रीजन. देर इज नो संगा एट ऑल. कल्पिता मिराज वॉटर हैज नो संगा विद द असंग डेजर्ट लैंड. देयरफॉर द सैंड डज नॉट गेट वेट. इट हैज अधिष्ठान अस्पर्श. सो अधिष्ठान इट डज नॉट हैव एनी स्पर्श विद दी कल्पित. सो कल्पित अधिष्ठान अस्पर्शित्वात् देर इज नो स्पर्श, देर फोर आत्मा असंग विल रिमेन असंग. इट डज नॉट हैव एनी संगा ऑल्सो, द संगा इज मिथ्या. ठीक है, कल्पित अधिष्ठान सह वास्तविक संबंध रहितत्वाद इत्यर्थ. देर इज नो वास्तविक संबंध, संबंध इज देर बट इट इज कल्पित संबंध. कल्पित संबंध कैनॉट हैव वास्तव असंगत्व हानि, दट इज दी हेतु देर. संबंध से आध्यासिकत्वाद अस्ति एव अविद्यासंगः, बट इज देर नो अविद्यासंग देन, नो यू कैनॉट से अविद्यासंग इजंट देर. इट इज देर बट इज कल्पित. एज लॉन्ग एज प्रपंच इज देर कारण वी शुड टॉक अबाउट, बिकॉज कार्य कैनॉट बी विदाउट कारण. दैट कारण नीड नॉट बी सत्य कारण, इट कैन बी मिथ्या कारण ऑल्सो, बट कारण हैज टू बी देर. इट कैन बी अनुमित ऑल्सो, देर फोर कार्यानुमेय माया हैज टू बी टॉक्ड अबाउट, अविद्या हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड. एंड सिंस अविद्या इज देर विच कैनॉट, बींग जड़ा कैनॉट एक्ट बाय इटसेल्फ, देर फोर अधिष्ठान ब्रह्मसत्ता ऑल्सो हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड एज हैविंग संग. वॉट संग? कल्पित संग, बिकॉज मिथ्या अविद्या माया कैनॉट हैव वास्तविक संबंध विथ सदात्मा सद्ब्रह्म विच इज असंग. सो असंगत्व हानि इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज मिथ्या माया मिथ्या अविद्या कैनॉट हैव रियल संग. इनफैक्ट इट इज मिथ्या. सो बीइंग मिथ्या हाउ कैन देयर बी सत् वास्तविक संबंध? इट कैन हैव ओनली कल्पित संबंध. बीइंग कल्पित इट कैन हैव कल्पित संबंध, नॉट वास्तविक संबंध वास्तविक संग. सो संबंध से आध्यासिकत्वाद इट इज अध्यस्त इन ब्रह्मात्मा, अज्ञान इज अध्यस्त, देर फोर अस्ति एव अविद्यासंग तस्य तस्य अवास्तिकत्व भावेन अवास्तिक अवास्तविक इट इज कल्पित. सो अवास्तविक अवास्तविक कत्व भावेन न असंगत्व हानिर इति भावः. सो बीइंग कल्पित देयर इज नो असंगत्व हानिः. प्रथम शंका निरासे युक्त्यंतरम आह. नाउ अनदर लॉजिक इज गिवन टू रिफ्यूट दी अर्लियर शंका अबाउट इन स्वप्रकाश आत्मा हाउ कैन देयर बी तमो रूप अविद्या नित्येति. रत्न प्रभा नित्य स्वरूप ज्ञानस्य अविरोधित्वात् चैति. सो चकारात् चकारात् अनदर हेतु इज बीइंग गिवन. नित्य स्वरूप ज्ञानस्य अविरोधित्वात् स्वप्रकाश आत्मा एंड तमो रूप अविद्या हाउ कैन देयर बी एनी एसोसिएशन एंड अधिष्ठान आधेय भाव. सो अधिष्ठान आधेय अधिष्ठान भाव विच इज बीइंग मेंशन्ड, हाउ कैन दैट बी? आत्मा इज स्वप्रकाश, इट कैनॉट बी वेल्ड, एंड तमो रूप अविद्या कैनॉट बी इन आत्मा, जस्ट लाइक डार्कनेस कैनॉट बी इन द सन. सॉरी, नाउ आत्मा इज स्वप्रकाश स्वरूप चित स्वरूप, but that chaitanya has virodha with nothing, does not, there is nothing existent other than chaitanya, that's a different matter. But even if you say something is there, yat kinchit bhava rupa avidya avidya karyava karyava prapanchova bhavatu, but is there any opposition of this सद्ब्रह्म स्वप्रकाश चिद्ब्रह्म ब्रह्मात्मा विथ एनीथिंग एल्स? देर इज नो ऑपोजिशन एट ऑल, अदरवाइज देर वोंट बी एनी भान ऑफ एनीथिंग. सिंस देर इज भान ऑफ समथिंग, समथिंग इज नोन, वाई इज इट नोन? बिकॉज चैतन्य स्वरूप इज बाय स्वरूप बाय इट्स ओन स्वभाव एनीथिंग इन इट्स प्रेजेंस मिथ्या ऑल्सो विल गेट रिवील्ड. So it is just revealing what is there, that there is avidya is also known by oneself. Not only do you know whether I understand, you also know whether I have not understood also. How so? Because the ajnana is also revealed by the same atma which reveals jnana also. So ajnana karya is also revealed by the same atma which is chitsvarupa, bhanarupa, bhasakarupa. So that which reveals everything in its presence has no opposition to anything else. So where is the opposition really? Where is the virodha? So when you say ajnana, we saw yesterday that ajnana nanj is not abhava rupa nanj, but it is virodharte. It is not abhavarte, it is virodharte. So virodha is between what and what? Ajnana and jnana. Not Satchidananda or Satyam Jnanam Anantam. That Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, Lakshana Jnanam Brahma. Satyam Brahma, Jnanam Brahma, Anantam Brahma. There Jnanam Brahma. Jnana is Lakshana of Brahma. What is Brahma? Jnanam. There Jnana means Chit, Chaitanya. But Jnana and Ajnana Virodha, when we talk about Ajnana as Jnana Virodhi and Jnana as Ajnana Virodhi, their Jnana, which is Virodhi to Ajnana, is not this Chidrupa Jnana, not Jnanam Brahma Jnana. The Vritti Rupa Brahma Jnana is Virodhi to Ajnana. And ajnana is virodhi to that kind of vritti rupa jnana, brahma jnana. Vritti rupa brahma jnana. Meaning, brahmakara vritti. Brahmakara vritti, which is jnana, that and ajnana have virodha with each other. Whichever is stronger wins over. So ajnana is anadikalena there, so it is stronger. Vritti rupa jnana has to be built by Shravanadi. So far it has not been there, therefore Ajnana has been stronger and overpowering. We can't even say overpowering, but we can say in one way that Samjnana of Atma is definitely there. At least we know that we exist. So Sadrupa is in one way or the other revealed. We know that we are conscious, therefore Chidrupa is also in one way or other revealed in Vritti. Because in Antakarana there is some understanding, in Buddhi some understanding of who I really am. That is there for each and every prani. The lion may not know what is one's own swarupa, in the sense that I am different from the body. The lion may not even understand anything else other than the simple instinctual life. With some training, it may understand something. It may not have that meta knowledge that I know that I know. But a human being has that. I know that I know. Not only do I know that I am conscious, I also know that I am conscious. I also know that I know that I am conscious. So there is meta knowledge also in human beings with a refined buddhi. Therefore, there is some understanding, although one avoids the inquiry, because the inquiry without help is frustrating. Then people take to something else to kill the time. Because when one is without any work to do, the mind wants to do something and leads to frustration as to the empty mind. Generally, left to oneself, one may think, you know, what is this life and all that. That kind of question, philosophical thought may come up, which is frustrating for most without help. So they want to kill time to keep the mind busy. As a general rule, if you inquire into it. So one knows one's own swarupa, but mithyatvena. There is a brahma that I am having these dharmas which do not belong to myself, they belong to the sthula and sukshma sharira. But since ajnana is revealed by the same chaitanya swarupa atma, एंड अज्ञान हैज बीन स्ट्रॉन्गर देन द वृत्ति रूप ब्रह्मज्ञान आत्मज्ञान देयरफॉर वन हैज नॉट अंडरस्टूड वन्स ओन रियल स्वरूप एंड देयर इज आवरण शक्ति विच इज मोर पावरफुल thereby vikshepa is taken as satya. This is the setup that we are in now so far, and having done shravana, what has happened is that the vritti becomes stronger, vritti roopa jnana becomes stronger, and it, the brahmakara vritti, once it is formed, if it is strong and one can hold on to it over and over again and again, then it will overpower ajnana. And ajnana nasha takes place. Nasha can take place only if it is yatkinchit bhava rupa at least. Abhava rupa needs no nasha. It cannot have nasha at all. Therefore also bhava rupa ajnana has to be talked about. When we say in English also, your ignorance will go away. If ignorance is lack of knowledge, how can lack, absence go away? So it is like a double negative, an absence. So, knowledge will take away absence of knowledge. That is a ridiculous statement, really. So, knowledge will take away ignorance. Knowledge will take away absence of knowledge. If ignorance is absence of knowledge, then how can you say knowledge will take away absence of knowledge? Tarkika's language is different. So, he'll say abhava goes away. Pratyogi. Abhava pratyogi will take away abhava. Anyway, that's also something to think about as to ajnana being bhavarupa. सो नित्य स्वरूप ज्ञानस्य अविरोधित्वात् चैति नित्य स्वरूप ज्ञान चिद्रूप ज्ञान सत्यम ज्ञानम ब्रह्म दैट काइंड ऑफ ज्ञान हैज नो विरोध विथ अज्ञान लेट देयर बी तमो रूप इट इज देयर इट हैज नो विरोध देयर इट रिवील्स दैट तमस आल्सो Just like a bright light in a particular area will reveal the darkness in the other areas. It does not light it up, but you will know that there is darkness further. When you see the light here, then you will be able to see. So something like that. Not exactly so, but something like that. We can understand how the Chidrupa Jnana reveals Ajnana also. It is Anubhava Siddha to us. Not understanding something is Ajnana, or Ajnana is shown. What is it shown by? It is shown by the same Swarupa of the Atma. I know that I do not know. Even if someone says, no, you have understood, I can very well say that I have not understood. So I am the only Pramana there. Atma is the only Pramana there, in the sense, reflexive Atma. I know that I do not know. How do I know that? Not by someone else saying. Someone else can tell me if I claim to know and then the other says that no, this is not how it is. Oh, it is not so. Then I have understood differently. Therefore, also I know my vikshepa, understanding of something different from what it is. But thereby my ajnana is revealed. Tika, vrityaruda jnanam eva ajnana virodhi iti bhava. So what is the meaning as to chaitanya rupa jnana? Atmajnana is not opposed to Swarupa. Jnana is not opposed to anything, including Tamorupa Jnana. So, Swaprakasha Atma, Chidrupa Atma is not opposed to Tamorupa. The Virodha Tamav Prakashavad Viruddha Swabhava, although it is there is no Virodha in the sense of Satya and Mithya cannot have any Virodha. It is like saying that I have a nightmare where I saw somebody who is my enemy now, sworn enemy, because, you know, he did something, he tried to hurt me in the dream. Is there a virodha of you with the enemy there? Definitely the enemy, there is a virodha, but the virodha is of the dreamer with that enemy. The dream enemy and the dream you have virodha. But can you claim to say that I have virodha with that dream enemy now in the waking state? There is no virodha. Even if you know the person, who came into your dream as an enemy, that person may not be an enemy here. He tried to hurt you in the dream, but there is no virodha at all. So where is the virodha? Only in the dream. So with this vritti, which is mithya, that mithya jnana vritti, brahmakara vritti is also mithya. Brahma is satya, everything other than Brahma is mithya. Therefore, vritti is vritti brahma, vritti is not brahma. Then what is vritti? Vritti is also called a jnana. Is it that chidrupa jnana? It isn't. The vritti rupa jnana is not chidrupa brahma. Chidrupa jnana it isn't. It is not brahma. Therefore, it is mithya. So that mithya vritti rupa jnana has opposition, has virodha with mithya jnana. There is no virodha between different sattas or karyas in different satya. Satta, karya in different satta cannot have virodha with karana in another satta. The waker is karana to the dream, who himself appears as the dreamer as well as the enemy also in the dream. So there is no virodha there. The virodha is between the mithya prativhasika, you, and the prativhasika enemy in the dream. Similarly here, vrityarudha jnanam eva ajnana virodhi iti bhavaha, natu swarupa jnanam. So swarupa jnanasya avirodhitvat means vrityarudha jnanam eva ajnana virodhi iti bhava. Athava, another way to look at it, athava jnana jnanayoho virodhat katham jnana rupatmani ajnanam ityatah. Or the shanka can be that earlier shanka was mentioned differently. Now the shanka is, athva, how can jnana and ajnana, ajnana and ajnana by tarkika's perspective, ajnana means jnana virodhi. Therefore, jnana and ajnana have virodha with each other, which I already explained earlier with the danj pratyaya. So that can be the shanka there and the nithya iti. This is the answer to that. Cha shabda shanka nirasartha. So cha. Cha has been used here. Nitya swarupa jnanasya avirodhitvat cha iti. So that cha means it is to take away the doubt with a second hetu also. Cha shabda shanka nirasartha. So cha shabda is a samasa. Cha iti shabda. Cha iti shabda. Cha shabda. Tarkika mata nirasartham mithya padam ityaha. So why mithya has been used? Mithya jnana nimittaha. So mithya, the reason the word mithya has been used because ajnana can be thought of as abhava rupa also, and tarkikas do think of that as the first reason because they say padarthas, in padartha there is abhava also. Abhava is also padartha. But abhava is what? It is not bhava padartha, it is abhava padartha. So they differentiate between all others which are bhava padarthas and abhava, although it is a padartha. Padartha meaning padasyartha. Padasyartha padartha, so abhava has some artha, therefore abhava is also padartha. But it is not a bhava padartha. So they say ghata abhava is there. So that astitva is talked about because there is padartha in abhava also. Ghata abhava is a padartha. Bhutale ghato nasti, when you say there, what is there then? Bhutale ghata abhava asti. That is another way to look at it. So they say that that abhava, ghata abhava is a padartha which is there in bhutala on the ground. The pot, abhava of the pot is there. So tarkika mata nirasartham mithya padam ityaha. Therefore ajnana is not abhava of jnana, but it is mithya. So that mithya is technical. Now what is mithya now? How can you say tarkika mata ajnana isn't the meaning? Meaning abhavarthe nanj isn't the meaning of nanj in the ajnana pada as considered by the tarkika. So how that nirasa is being done by the word mithya, because mithya also means nasti. This can be the thinking. So therefore mithya and ajnana going together will mean it isn't there. Ajnana is something which is not there, meaning jnana isn't there. That is not true. Why? Because if ajnana means abhava of jnana, then the mithya word also meaning nasti would be superfluous. Why would Bhagavan Bhashyakara use it? So mithya word does not mean abhava. So mithya plus ajnana together, when ajnana can itself mean abhava of jnana, adding mithya would be superfluous. Therefore mithya does not mean same as ajnana, jnana abhava, and ajnana also does not mean jnana abhava. This is the idea why mithya has been additionally added. Yadva iti. So there in the Ratna Prabha, Yadva ajnanam jnana abhava iti shanka nirasartham mithyapadam. So mithyapada can also be due to this reason, as to there is a doubt. Ajnana means jnanasya abhava. It is not jnanasya abhava, it is not lack of jnana, it is not absence of jnana. Therefore mithya word has been used. Then what is mithya now? Tika lakshyamsha shesha purtya lakshanadvayam yojayati. So now I'll go through this section not with a lot of detail of the tika, because tikakara has done two types of divisions. He says either it is lakshyamsha shesha purtya or lakshyamsha shesha purtya na, meaning filling something which is not there in the lakshya, or to complete the lakshya something has been added. So both are perspectives which are given, which is a little tricky to look into, but we'll see what is the as to differentiate between these two may be a little tricky, as to lakshyamsha purti and lakshyamsha apurti, or not for rather let me say to the for the purti of lakshyamsha or not for the purti of lakshyamsha. There are two pakshas created, but we look at what exactly is discussed. That will be the focus. Thereby lakshana dvayam yojayati. Anyway, mithya, what is mithya now? Lakshana of mithya, what is the definition of mithya? So there are two definitions given, and therefore lakshana dvayam yojayati by lakshyamsha shesha purti mithyatve sati ityadina. So mithyatve sati, what is not there in the bhashya, additionally it has been shown here as to what the word mithya means. Because Bhagavan Bhashyakara says mithya, what is the meaning of mithya? So Ratna Prabhakara defines mithya. Defines ajnana itself. So mithyatve sati sakshat jnana nivartyatvam. So lakshanadvayam, kasya lakshanadvayam? Ajnanasya. Meaning mithya ajnana nimitta. So mithya and ajnana are in karmadharaya. Mithya chatad ajnanancha. Now ajnana is mithya. What is the lakshana of ajnana? It is mithya. So now mithya and ajnana, these are the only two words. So something is added to explain it for multiple reasons. Therefore two lakshanas are given. What is ajnana? Mithyatve sati sakshat jnana nivartyatvam ajnanasya lakshanam mithya jnana padena uktam. The word mithya in the mithya jnana nimitta, along with ajnana, it is also said to be mithya. Therefore lakshana of ajnana is mithyatve sati sakshat jnana nivartyatvam. What is ajnana? Ajnana is jnana nivartyam. Ajnana is that which will go by jnana. That is the lakshana of ajnana. That is the meaning of the nanj there in jnana and ajnana. The a there, which is nanj, means jnana nivartya. Ajnana is that which will go by jnana. Will it go by jnana? How will it go by jnana? There are various ways in which the karana takes away the karya, as in Tarkika would say ghata. Ghata is pratyogi to abhava. So yasya abhava sa pratyogi. सो घटा घटा इज प्रतियोगी टू घटाभाव. वेन घटा कम्स इन देन देर इज विरोध. इफ वेन घटा इज मेड बिफोर द घटा वॉट वॉज देर घटाभाव वॉज देर घट प्रागभाव. सो प्रागभाव प्रतियोगी इज द घटा घटोत्पत्ति विल टेक अवे घट प्रागभाव एंड घटा कैनॉट बी टुगेदर इन द सेम अधिकरण दे कैनॉट बी देर इन द सेम काल दे आर अपोज टू ईच अदर. So this ajnana and jnana are opposed to each other. Once jnana comes in like ghata, then it will take away ajnana. So this is this similarity which a tarkika would see if you explain it in this manner. So there what has been said, no mithyatve sati sakshat jnana nivartyam ajnanam. If you take the meaning of ajnana as jnana nivartyam, still what is not there in the bhashya can be explained. Can be explained, nanj can be explained as jnana nivartyam ajnanam. However, the word sakshat is added. So anyway, I said I will not talk about it, but then it's difficult to not say something that you see. So here lakshyamsha shesha purtya, this sakshat has been additionally added there. Although ajnana can be explained as jnana nivartyatvam, ajnanatvam, nanj can be explained, sakshat word is additional. Why sakshat is added? That has to be inquired into now. So lakshana is what is mithya and what goes by jnana is ajnana. ज्ञानेन इच्छा प्रागभाव साक्षात् निवर्त्यते इति वदन्तं प्रति मिथ्यात्वे सति इत्युक्तम्. सो विल गो टू द टीका लेटर, सो आई कैन गो थ्रू इट क्विकली. वी लुक एट दिस सेक्शन एज टू द परीक्षा ऑफ द लक्षण इन तर्क. देर इज उद्देश विच इज जस्ट मेन्शनिंग अ संज्ञा. वॉट इज अज्ञान? अज्ञान इज जस्ट अ नेम गिवन टू समथिंग. That ajnana word introduction is called as uddesha. Then there is a lakshana which is definition. So kim nama ajnanam, there lakshana is given as to mithyatve sati sakshat jnana nivartyatvam, ajnanasya lakshanam. So lakshana is given definition. Then does this definition have dosha? Ativyapti, avyapti, asambhava dosha, those are analyzed. That analysis is called as pariksha. So your lakshana should reach only what is lakshya, what is intended to be defined, and it should not define something else, partly, fully, whatever. So your lakshana definition, if it does not define the set that you want to define completely, then it is avyapti. If it defines something other than what you want to define, meaning something you do not want to define also gets covered in that definition, then it is ativyapti dosha. If it does not cover anything in this set that you want to define, then it is asambhava dosha. So this was people who do not know what are ativyapti, avyapti and asambhava dosha. So the pariksha is being done now. Why mithyatve sati sakshat jnana nivartyatvam? Why so many words have been used? So jnanena ichha pragabhava sakshat nivartyate iti vadantam prati mithyatve sati yuktam. There is a ekadeshi in tarkikas also. Ekadeshi is one who has a different view, has a particular part view, or one who agrees partly with Tarkikas, not with everything that Tarkikas say. That kind of a Tarkika, he is also Tarkika. They are also logicians. They separate themselves out from the earlier Tarkikas and they say that I agree with what have you said, but not completely, partly. So what do they have a view of? Ghata takes away ghata bhava. So ghata is, ghata utpatti is karana for taking away the ghata pragava. Karana in the sense, ghata pragava is also karana for ghata to come up. Ghata is karya. Ghata won't come up if ghata pragava isn't there. So ghata pragava has to be accepted, and Tarkika's definition of karana is that which is immediately present before the karya utpatti. All that is considered as karana, barring some exceptions. where you know anyata siddha etc. But this without ghata pragabhava, there cannot be a ghata, and it should immediately precede the ghata. Therefore, ghata pragabhava is definitely a karana for ghata. Also, it is not anyata siddha, meaning without ghata pragabhava, using something else, you cannot bring about ghata. Ghata pragabhava being there alone, you can do it. So, ghata pragabhava isn't there, and you have everything else, still you cannot bring in ghata. Meaning, ghata pragabhava isn't there means what? If you have clay, you have kulala, you have the potter, you have the clay, you have the wheel, you have danda, all that you have. But ghata is also there. Which is the ghata you want to create? Then the potter wants to create, then he will not create it because it is already created. Therefore, ghata pragabhava has to be there. It is not anyata siddha. So this is an aside to explain what is this ekadeshi mata. Ekadeshi tarkika says, unlike the earlier tarkika, or generally the tarkika say that ghata takes away ghata pragabhava, this jnana nivartyatvam, jnana nivartyatvam ajnanasya lakshanam, had it been said, then the ekadeshi mata is what? Jnana iccha pragabhava sakshat nivartyate. Iti vadantam prati. Iti vadantam. Iti vadan is the ekadeshi. Tam prati. Mithyatvi satit yuktam. There what happens is jnana iccha pragabhava. So anyway, for this I'll need tika. I'll show in the tika. Jnana iccha pragabhava sakshat nivartyate. Iti vadantam prati. So what he says is that jnana iccha pragabhava. What happens is that there is janati. So anyway, I'll just go a little ahead and let's cover this. I'll come back to this. Let me explain the tika itself. So mithyatva sati saksha jnana nivartyattvam ajnanasya lakshanam mithya jnana padena uktam. Tika anirvachaniyatve sati. इत्यर्थः. सो व्हाट इज मिथ्या? अनिर् मिथ्या मीन्स अनिर्वचनीय, सरसद विलक्षण, अनिर्वचनीयत्वे सति इत्यर्थः. वी हैव सीन अनिर्वचनीय पद यस्टरडे, सो आई होप दैट इज अंडरस्टूड. सो मिथ्या मीन्स अनिर्वचनीय, नॉट नास्ति. अथवा भावत्वे सति इत्यर्थः. और व्हाट? भावत्वे सति, यत् किंचित् भावत्वे सति, नॉट अभाव रूप अज्ञान. फर्दर अज्ञानपदेन विवक्षितमर्थं आह, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द अज्ञान पद? साक्षात् ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम् अज्ञानम्. सो मिथ्या च तदज्ञानम् च मिथ्या ज्ञानम्. सो मिथ्या च तदज्ञानम् च मिथ्या ज्ञानम्, दैट इज कर्मधारय. देन तत्प्रतिपादकम् समासवाक्यम् यत्पदम् तेन इत्यर्थः. सो द समास इज कर्मधारय, इट इज नोन. एतेन पदद्वयस्य सत्वात् पदेन इत्येकवचनानुपपत्तिरिति निरस्तम्. पदस्य समास वाक्य रूपत्वेन अंगीकारात्. सो मिथ्या ज्ञान इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ पद, बट देर आर टू थिंग्स देयर, टू पदास आर देयर, बट मिथ्या ज्ञान इज ऑल्सो अ पद. ऑल्दो इट इज अ समास एंड हैज मल्टीपल पदास, मिथ्या ज्ञान इज ऑल्सो पद. वाय? कृत्तर्दित समासाश्च प्रातिपदिकम. सो प्रातिपदिका इज कृत्तर्दित समास ऑल्सो. कृदंत तद्दितांत एंड samasa is also pratipadika. So samasa can have multiple padas, but then it will become pratipadika and it will decline as a single pada. Therefore etena padadayasya sattvat, mithya and ajnana both are there. How do you say one pada is there? So there sattvat padena ityeka vachana anupapattir iti nirastam. You cannot say it is, why is it eka vachana? Because there are mithya jnanam is one pada, it is a karmadharya samasa. Although there are two padas within, by samasa it is one pada. Padasya samasa vakya rupatvena angikara. So pada is samasa vakya is considered as a pada, single pada. Although it is the samasa vigraha vakya is multiple padas, as in mithya cha tad ajnanam cha. So many words have been used, but mithya jnanam is a single pada anyway. Anyway, that's an aside. It's, you know, in the context something has been mentioned. Jnana ghatita hi iccha. उत्पत्ति सामग्री एव इच्छा प्रागभाव नाश हेतु न तो इच्छा इति एकदेशी सिद्धांतम अनुवदन पदकृत्यम आह। सो देर दी तार्किक एकदेशी से ज्ञान घटिता ही इच्छा उत्पत्ति सामग्री एव इच्छा प्रागभाव नाश हेतु। सो घटा इफ यू वांट टू क्रिएट अ घटा व्हाट हैज बीन सेड ज्ञाने इति फर्दर इट इज सेड जानाति इच्छति यतते इति न्यायेन। फर्स्ट यू नीड घट ज्ञान टू मेक घट सो जानाति देन इच्छति ऑल्दो यू नो हाउ टू मेक अ पॉट यू मे नॉट डिजायर दैट यू वांट अ पॉट यू डोंट डिजायर टू मेक अ पॉट यू डोंट डिजायर अ पॉट देन यू वोंट मेक इट। सो व्हेन द पॉट इज मेड देर इज ज्ञान अबाउट पॉट हाउ टू मेक इट देर इज डिजायर फॉर द पॉट and therefore jnanati icchati and then yatate yatate prayatate one does prayatna one does karma to create the ghata so jnanati icchati yatate iti nyayena jnanantaram iccha jayate jnanena eva iccha pragavascha nashyati iti vadantam tarkika ekadeshinam prati ichyartha। सो तम प्रति दिस इन द रत्न प्रवा ज्ञान इच्छा प्रागभाव साक्षात निवर्त्यते इति वदन्तं प्रति मिथ्यात्वे सति इत्युक्तम्। सो व्हाट द एकदेशी सेज इज दैट जस्ट लाइक घटा विल टेक अवे घट प्रागभाव एज मेंशन्ड बाय द अदर्स अदर तार्किकास ही सेज दैट ज्ञान एव इच्छा प्रागभावश्च ज्ञानेनैव ही सेज फर्स्ट जानाति देन इच्छति देन यतते। सो ज्ञाने इति न्यायेन ज्ञानांतरम इच्छा जायते द इच्छा इज बॉर्न आफ्टर ज्ञान ऑफ व्हाटएवर कार्य दैट यू वांट टू डू कर्म कर्म फॉलोज यत्न फॉलोज। सो इच्छा जायते कदा जायते ज्ञानानंतरम therefore ज्ञानेने एव इच्छा प्रागभावश्च नश्यति। so he says this he has a very peculiar view as to this ज्ञान will take away इच्छा and प्रागभाव इच्छा प्रागभाव sorry इच्छा प्रागभाव he says इच्छा इच्छा प्रागभाव once ज्ञान comes in then this ichha follows right so janati ichhati so jnana ghata jnana let's take an example is ghata jnana one gets after getting ghata jnana what happens ichha comes up now the earlier tarkika what ichha so ghata jnana is there ghata ichha comes up I'm giving a very simple example so consider that you have ghata jnana how to make ghata so how to make ghata that jnana you have then oh I can make it let me make it so you can take a cooking example maybe better you take some example of cooking you have want to cook something so you let's say khadya some khadya so khadya jnana is there khadya jnana so we have lot of resources now so sitting at home watch some youtube video and then oh there is ichha oh this is this looks good I know how to make it let's make it सो ज्ञानेन एव इच्छा प्रागभावश्च नश्यति इति। सो ज्ञान ऑफ दैट खाद्य खाद्य पदार्थ सो खाद्य ज्ञान केम अप खाद्य इच्छा हैज कम अप आफ्टर दैट द तार्किका जनरल जनरल तार्किका वुड से व्हाट दिस इच्छा फॉर खाद्य खाद्य इच्छा गोज अवे बाय व्हाट सॉरी खाद्य इच्छा अभाव खाद्य इच्छा हैज कम अप सो बिफोर द खाद्य इच्छा अभाव वॉज देयर जस्ट लाइक बिफोर घट घटोत्पत्ति घट अभाव वॉज देयर प्राग अभाव ऑफ घट नाउ हियर इच्छा हैज कम अप खाद्य इच्छा सो अर्लियर तार्किका द जनरल तार्किका वुड से व्हाट सो आई विल से तार्किका एंड तार्किक एकदेशी तार्किका वुड से दैट खाद्य इच्छा विल टेक अवे खाद्य इच्छा प्राग अभाव इच्छा प्रागव विल गो बाय इच्छा उत्पत्ति खाद्य इच्छा उत्पत्ति दी एकदेशी तार्किक एकदेशी ही सेज jnana of that khadya has come up and that gives rise to ichha. So ichha pragaba which was there is taken away by the earlier jnana. The earlier jnana is the khadya jnana itself will take away, gives rise to ichha. Khadya ichha. Therefore, khadya ichha pragabhava nasha is due to the jnana. Khadya jnana. So, khadya jnana takes away khadya ichha pragabhava. Not that ichha comes up, khadya ichha comes up and then khadya ichha pragabhava goes away. So, the earlier, meaning what precedes and is the cause for something some bhava padartha, that itself will take away the abhava of that karya bhava padartha. That is the tarkika ekadhi. So here what will happen? Here, tathacha ichha pragabhave lakshanasya ativyaptihi. If you say mithyatve sati jnana nivartyatvam, then what will happen? In that ekadeshi mata, whatever he says is that ichha pragabhava. Ichha pragabhava is what? Ichha pragabhava is that which goes by jnana. So jnana nivartyatvam, if your lakshana is what? Sakshat jnana nivartyatvam. Only sakshat jnana nivartyatvam ajnanam. If it is your lakshana, then the ekadeshi tarkika will say ichha also goes away. Ichha pragabhava also goes away by jnana. Ghata ichha pragabhava goes by ghata jnana. How to make ghata, that jnana. Ghata, by ghata jnana, I don't mean what is ghata. I mean ghata sadhana jnana, let's say. So ghata sadhana, how to make ghata. So or we can say what? Ghata kaushalya, kulala. Kulala jnana, kulala has the ghata jnana, how to make ghata also. So ghata jnana is complete there with the samagri. And how to make the ghata. So that kind of jnana I mean by ghata jnana. So the ghata jnana takes away ghata ichha pragabhava. Similarly here this ichha pragabhava goes by jnana. So saksha jnana nivartyatvam if you say is ajnana, then is ajnana ichha pragabhava? It is not. But you have ativyapti there because your lakshana definition reaches there. Therefore, what has been done? Mithyatve sati. But the khadya jnana or ghata jnana itself is not mithya jnana. In vyavaharika, they are satya jnana. Therefore, there is no ativyapti in ichha pragabhava by adding mithyatve sati. So, mithyatve sati has been mithyatva. Has been added, being mithya, it is should be mithya also. Ajnana is that which is mithya, whereas ichha pragabhava is not mithya. Therefore, mithya pada mithyatva has been added. Mithya, mithyatve sati saksha jnana nivartyatvam. Prathama vyakhyanena mithyatvam anirvachaniyatvam ajnanam nama avidya समासस्तु कर्मधारया लक्ष्यांशस्य न शेषपूर्ति तथा च मिथ्याज्ञानमित्यनेन भाष्येण अविद्या रूप अज्ञानस्य अनिर्वचनीयत्वं अक्षरारूढ लक्षणं इत्युक्तं भवति इति ज्ञापितम्. सो बाय यूजिंग कर्मधारय मिथ्या एंड अज्ञान एंड मिथ्या एज हैविंग द मीनिंग ऑफ अनिर्वचनीय एज इट इज द लक्षण होल्ड्स गुड. नाउ एडिशनली व्हाट हैज बीन एडेड यद्वा इति हियर by saying yadva ajnanam jnana bhaviti shanka nirasartam mithyapadam, then mithyatve sati. Additionally, something has been added to give the mithyatva saksha jnana nivartyatvam. So yadva iti dvitiya vyakhyane na mithyatvam bhavatvam ajnanam nama saksha jnana nivartyam samasastu karmadhare lakshamsha sheshapurti tatacha bhavatve sati saksha jnana nivartyatvam ajnana lakshanam तात्पर्येण मिथ्याज्ञानपदेन बोधितमिति दर्शितम्. सो विथ मिथ्याज्ञान पद इन दि भाष्य व्हाट हैज बीन सेड, मिथ्या मीन्स अनिर्वचनीयत्वे सति और भावत्वे सति अज्ञानम्. एंड शेषपूर्त्या टू ऐड व्हाट इज एडिशनली मिसिंग देयर इज साक्षात. व्हाई दैट इज आल्सो गोइंग टू बी एक्सप्लेन्ड. साक्षात इज एडिशन बाय रत्नप्रभाकर अदरवाइज देर इज अतिव्याप्ति। इदानीं मिथ्यात्वं नाम ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वं अज्ञानं नाम अनाद्युपादानम् इति विवक्षा व्याख्यानांतरम् अभिप्रेत्य अज्ञानस्य लक्षणांतरम् आह। बिफोर वी गो टू दी अदर लक्षण विच विल गो इन दी नेक्स्ट पार्ट, आई विल फिनिश ऑफ दिस पार्ट व्हाट इज लेफ्ट देयर इन दी रत्नप्रभा व्याख्यान, जस्ट वन पार्ट, अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा। सो वाई मिथ्यात्व सति हैज बीन एडेड इन दी लक्षण मिथ्यात्व सति, दैट इज बिकॉज अदरवाइज देर वुड बी अतिव्याप्ति इन इच्छा प्रागभाव एज पर दी तार्किक एकदेशी। देन वाई साक्षात पद हैज बीन एडेड, यू कुड हैव सेड मिथ्यात्व सति अज्ञान निवर्त्यत्व, सॉरी मिथ्यात्व सति ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्व अज्ञानस्य लक्षणम्, वाई साक्षात पद विच इज शेषपूर्त्य अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा ज्ञान निवृत्ति बंधे अतिव्याप्ति निराशाय साक्षारिति। अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा ज्ञान निवृत्ति बंधे अतिव्याप्ति, व्हाट इज बंध, बंध इज मिथ्या, सो मिथ्यात्व सति बंध इज मिथ्या, सो मिथ्यात्व सति दैट मिथ्यात्वम इज देयर इन बंध। व्हाट अबाउट ज्ञान निवर्त्यत्वम, बंध इज ज्ञान निवर्त्य और नॉट, इट इज ज्ञान निवर्त्य। When jnana, brahma jnana takes place, then mithya bandha goes away. How does it go away? First, there is ajnana nasha, not sakshat. Directly bandha, bandha is what? Dukkha rupa bandha. Samsara, samsarana rupa bandha. Does it go away immediately as in sakshat by brahma jnana? No. Brahma jnana, although the ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस, बंधा डज नॉट गो अवे इमीडिएटली। व्हाट हैपेंस? फर्स्ट इट हैज टू टेक अवे अज्ञान, व्हेन इट इज पावरफुल इनफ टू टेक अवे द अज्ञान कंप्लीटली, देन व्हेन अज्ञान गोज अवे, अज्ञान बीइंग कारण ऑफ दिस बंध विच इज कार्य, बंध ऑल्सो गोज अवे। सो कारण नाशे कार्य नाश, बट दैट कारण नाश हैज टू टेक प्लेस। कारण नाश इज साक्षात अविद्या ज्ञाश नाश, अज्ञान नाश इज साक्षात बाय ज्ञान, दैट इज ज्ञान निवर्त्य। बंध इज ऑल्सो ज्ञान निवर्त्य, बट इट इज नॉट साक्षात, इट इज परंपराया, इट इज आफ्टर द अज्ञान गोज अवे एज कार्य निवृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस बिकॉज ऑफ कारण निवृत्ति, देयरफॉर बंध निवृत्ति टेक्स प्लेस। देयरफॉर इफ यू डोंट से साक्षात, मिथ्यात्वम इज देर इन बंध एंड ज्ञान निवर्तित्वम इज ऑल्सो देर इन बंध, देर फोर बंधे अतिव्याप्ति स्यात्। अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा ज्ञान निवर्त्य बंधे, दी ज्ञान निवर्त्य बंध विच इज मिथ्या ऑल्सो देर बी अतिव्याप्ति, बट इट इज अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा, देर इज अ क्रम, इट इज नॉट साक्षात, देर फोर अतिव्याप्ति निराशा है साक्षारिति। वंस यू से साक्षात, देन अज्ञान निवृत्ति द्वारा मीन्स नॉट साक्षात, देर फोर बंध विच इज ऑल्सो ज्ञान निवर्त्य एंड मिथ्या, इट इज नॉट साक्षात ज्ञान निवर्त्य, देर फोर देर इज नो अतिव्याप्ति देर। वी लुक एट द नेक्स्ट लक्षण ऑफ अज्ञान इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ। यम ह्य कारुणिकम शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदम् तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिं। नमस्ते।